Men, this is a review of the Thompson Center Compass. This has been done as part as a larger review where we have five guns under $350. So definitely check out that video that kind of reviews all five. But in this video, we're going to go all in depth just on one
Thompson
gun.
Center. So we bought it in 30-06, chambered in 30-06. I will say one thing about it. The recoil pads, not too bad.
That's good. That's good. Because the stock, like, it just looks really cheesy and cheap, the stock. Like, I just, the design of it, I just do not care for. Like, there's major
give here
in the stock. It is not at all stiff. Like, it looks and feels like a $350 gun.
Right.
Further on the build quality, with the bolt release, like,
there's a
have to press it halfway down. If you press it all the way, it won't go.
It won't go.
You got to go halfway down.
Trying to put the bolt in, I spent like 5 minutes on this thing. I'm like, I am pushing this all the way down. What is going on? And we finally figured it out. You just had to be a pansy and only push it down halfway.
You're too much of a man. Too much of a man for a Thompson Center Compass. I do like that it has a threaded barrel. That's really nice for a suppressor, for a muzzle brake, whatever you're going to do on there.
Yeah.
Flash hider, so you can be all sniper. We do have metal sling studs, which at this price point is actually a feature. It has a plastic trigger guard. The safety, some people like. I don't care for it. I just want a simple dang-tang safety with my thumb.
Just do with my thumb.
But a lot of people do like it to lock right on the bolt.
And I should be able to tell. Like, looking at it without having to look for printed letters, I should be able to tell if it's unsafe or on fire.
It's not my preference, but it's not bad. It's, and some people might actually like it, so, you know, your bolt doesn't fly back as you're walking in the weeds and stuff, get caught on it.
Sure.
It's a thing. All right. Now, the real question is, how does the dang thing shoot? So we bought three different types of ammunition to put through this gun. And I had questions on what the accuracy would be that we measured because of this. So let's just do this live on camera here. So this is our trigger pull measure.
Yep.
I'll let you pull it there. You're more direct.
Yep. All right. Here we go. I want you to take a close look at that. Whoops. 5.5 pounds?
That is crazy. You got to get a running start. It's like Happy Gilmore. You're like, wah! That's weight is too heavy to shoot a gun accurately.
Most of them come at around 4 pounds, to maybe 4.5. But 5.5 pounds.
Yeah, and to be fair, it is adjustable, but it's complex. You got to move different nuts around.
And most people are just going to fire it as it came out of the box.
Exactly, and that's how we wanted to test these guns. They're inexpensive guns. You know, it's not going to be a, you know, extremely experienced marksman usually who's going to shoot a gun like this. And so we wanted to shoot it as it came from the factory as much as possible. So a 5.5 pound trigger weight, not acceptable. And it probably did impact the accuracy, which let's talk about now. So again, we shot more, but 8 groups in the official test. We took the 3 best 4-shot groups and the median of those 3 groups, because we wanted to knock out some of them because we probably made a mistake.
Sure.
We were on a pretty steady bench rest, but not that steady. It was in the back of a truck. There were some human errors in there.
Sure.
So we took the 3 best groups, and the average group size was 1.3485 inches at 100 yards, which, that's good, very good, in fact, for this level of gun at 100 yards. Like, that's a solid accuracy rating.
I could take this gun hunting and with high level of confidence that I'm going to hit what I aim for.
Any game out to 300 yards is going to be dead.
Yep.
You're going to get it. Now, this particular gun didn't come scoped. I'm sure you can get them scoped. How we bought this one was not scoped, but it was less expensive than the others.
It was about $100 less expensive than the others, which leaves me a nice, healthy room for an inexpensive...
Yeah, cheap Cabela scope or something, which is probably going to be better, almost certainly going to be better than the scope we got on the $350 ones that were scoped. They were...
Exactly.
Some of those scopes were crazy. So I actually love that this was sold unscoped, but for a lower price point.
Yes.
Much better as far as I'm concerned. Okay, so that's the Thompson Center Compass. Would you pick it, though?
Well, okay, so out of... Okay, if I have a choice of which gun to buy, it's not my first, second, or even third pick out of five. That tells you something. This isn't the gun I would buy. There is one factor, though, that almost pushes me over the edge to want to consider that, and that's the keychain.
This comes free with your purchase of a $250 gun.
Yeah.
It's stainless, heavy. It has a function. I didn't even know that.
It has a compass.
It has a compass.
It's a compass. The keychain is a compass, folks.
And that actually is where North is.
So Ricky. I don't know. This probably moves this from ranking number 4 to ranking number 3.9 in my book.
It's my number one pick. Go buy a Thompson Center Compass. Thanks for watching Backfire. We're working really hard on this channel. Please give us a subscribe, and then you'll see our new gun and hunting videos right in your feed.